Are you smart enough for medical school? Are you smart enough to get into medical school and become a doctor? Yes, this is a serious question. And a question that I'm going to guess keeps you up at night. A question that maybe when you voiced it to other people, they said, nah, you're smart enough. We believe in you. And you want to believe them. You want to know that they're right. But when you're lying in bed at night, and those thoughts start to just swim around your brain, you don't really believe them, do you? You start questioning it. Am I good enough? Am I even cut out for this? And when that happens, it doesn't matter what your family tells you. It doesn't matter if your friends support you. It doesn't even matter if you look in the mirror and say, I can do this. I am smart enough. Those affirmations are useless if deep down, that voice keeps coming back and saying, uh-uh. You're not smart enough. I'm not going to be another person who tells you, yeah, you're smart enough, you can do this. Because if you don't believe it, you're not going to believe me. So here's what I want you to do instead. The next time that voice pops up, I challenge you to stop, run the thoughts through your head, and say, so what? If I'm not smart enough, so what? Because if you try to contradict the thoughts when you don't believe it, it's not going to work. But if you say, okay, voice in my head, I'm not smart enough, and so what? Why would that keep me out of medical school? That's when you get the upper hand. Because let me tell you something, you do not have to be smart to get into medical school. When your pre-med advisor tells you, your grades aren't that good, maybe you should look into nursing. What he's really telling you is you don't match the perfect persona of the student that I'm used to advising. And because I don't know what to do, it's easier for me to just tell you to do something else. When a family member tells you, you've been studying for the MCAT for so long, why don't you just look into another career? What they're really telling you is we see you struggling. We don't want to see you struggling. So we're going to push you into something else where if you can't fail, we won't see you struggling anymore. But at the end of the day, if your dream is to become a doctor, if you can't see yourself doing anything else except for wearing that white coat or scrubs and working with patients on a day-to-day basis, you will never be happy doing something else. And if the only thing preventing you from reaching your goal is thinking that you're not smart enough, I'm going to challenge you and say, so what? I'm not saying that a low GPA or a bad MCAT score don't matter. The numbers absolutely matter. But the numbers don't say who you are. So yes, if you have poor grades or a low MCAT score, you're going to have a harder time. But that doesn't mean you have to give up, because it's not necessarily going to keep you out of medical school. I work mostly with non-traditional students. Students who have GPAs in the 3.0 and sometimes lower range. Students who've taken the MCAT more than once and they haven't done very well. But you know what? There's one thing in common with all of these students when they get into medical school. And that is the only thing that matters, not how smart you are. And what is that? That is the ability to be so stubborn that you don't know when to quit. So stubborn that you don't know how to quit. So stubborn that you will never give up. And if that means working twice as hard or 10 times as hard as your fellow pre-meds, then so be it. And I'm going to argue that not only is this going to overcome any potential lack of intelligence that you think you have, but this is also going to help you do better. Because if you know what it's like to struggle for your results, if you know what it's like to work so hard to reach a goal, by the time you get to medical school, you will know how to get through medical school. And when you finally get that degree, when you finally become a doctor, you're going to appreciate that so much more because of how hard you worked to get here. I have worked with thousands of pre-med students. Some of them brilliant, and some that are less brilliant, that have to work so hard to get a score that is just good enough. But you know what? That's good enough. And you know what they call the student who graduates last in their class in medical school? You guessed it, doctor. To reiterate, actually, first give this video a thumbs up, then make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. So the next time that voice in your head tries to ask you, am I smart enough to become a doctor? I challenge you to change that question. One, am I stubborn enough to refuse to quit? And two, am I willing to work as hard as it takes, no matter how long it takes, to reach my goal? And if the answer is yes, I am willing to do whatever it takes because my dream is to become a doctor, then nothing, and I mean nothing, is going to stand in your way. Are you willing to do whatever it takes? Let me know in the comments below.